Hi friends, welcome to Azure Data Lake video tutorials. This session I am going to start with what is exactly Azure Data Lake Store and how to create Azure Data Lake Store and how we are going to use in data integration process, like how we will migrate the data from different sources and how we will copy the data and how to delete the files in Data Lake Store and how we can create a folders in Data Lake Store. Okay. So first, what is exactly data lake storage? Before going to data lake storage, first we should know what is exactly data lake. So this is a common concept in nowadays in cloud computing. So in cloud technologies, data lake means in a lake you can store any type of data. It's like structured data, unstructured data and semi-structured data, like any database data, like whatever you have tables and columns and whatever you have rows is structured data. Semi-structured data like JSON files, XML files, and unstructured data for log files, whatever you have, a system logs. Okay, this is all information if you want to store and if you want to analyze. So we can store any type of data and any size of data as well. So Azure Cloud Storage is accepting, we can store any size, any type, we can ingest all this data and we can go for doing analytics, like we can analyze the data in Azure Cloud. So this is a major concept of data lake store. Okay, so and there are two versions is available, Azure Data Lake Store version generation 1 and generation 2. Generation 2 is the latest version. It's supporting with blob structure as well. So earlier Data Lake Store is a file system based, and you can use sample file system like folder structure, as well as you can use with the web HDFS. Okay, with Hadoop, if you install HD Insight cluster and if you configure web HDFS, you can use this REST API based, like you can access through any third party tools, you can access using this web HDFS. Okay, and that's everything data will be accomplished, and it will support all the features like security, manageability, scalability and reliability and availability. So these are the features it's supporting. It's like a database, but here you can store any type of data like structured, flat files with header, like any delimited files, and semi-structured like XML, JSON files, unstructured like log files, any system logs. You can store anywhere data lake store. So this is the major concept of Azure Data Lake Store. Let's go to more detail. So what are the features, like why we are going for only Azure Data Lake Store when we are storing this data? It's a open source compatibility. It's a open source compatibility and unlimited storage, like petabyte storage. And obviously you will be having a doubts related to amount, like this amount you have to pay as per usage, as per your jobs. That's called scales instantly. Pay as per your jobs, as per your usage. For example, today if you are using 1 TB, that's you have to pay for that. That's pay as you go. Okay, pay as you for usage. And MPP, it supports MPP, massively parallel processing. So when you are copying data, when you are deleting data, when you are moving data from one data lake folder to another data lake, when you are moving from one data lake to another data lake, same data lake, within data lake, if you are copying the files from one folder to another folder, so that's a massively parallel processing. Okay, then enterprise grade security. Okay, it's applying all the security features, so no need to worry about the your files. Then it's integrate seamlessly with the existing infrastructure, so whatever you have existing infrastructure, so you can integrate here. And hybrid ETL transformations you can, it will support. Like if you are doing ETL transformations, like ETL or ELT transformations, like copying data from source to staging, staging to target, same thing from if you are approaching ELT approach. So it will support, it will support your hybrid transformations like ETL or ELT. So we can use this data lake store. This is the major features I can say we can use this data lake store, or as per source, as per target, as a store, temporary app. You can use archive logs. So it's massively, you can store and you can copy the files, how much data you are receiving from source, those files you can copy. So it's not a matter about size. So it's a trillions of objects also you can copy, like small size objects also you can copy here. There's a concept of data lake store. So this diagram is showing how we are using a data lake store. This is generation one. If we look at here, devices information and the social media, these are unstructured data. If you see here, social media, whatever you have with charting, logs, videos, sensors, and streaming data as well, this all unstructured data. And relational is nothing but a structured data. And web is like, you can using the STAP, you can export as a semi-structured data like XML or JSON format, large objects applications, okay, big files. So this structured data, unstructured data, semi-structured data, all this data we can ingest into our data lake store. So there we will maintain multiple file structure, that's a folders, you can say hierarchy. All my files will goes to videos will goes to one folder, and all my social logs will goes to one folder, and my all large applications will data will goes to one folder, and semi-structured data, web XML or maybe JSON file will goes to one folder. Relational data, maybe you can say delimited files data will goes to one folder. Streaming data, my streaming data will goes to one folder. Like this, I can maintain multiple folders in my data lake, and I can manage the access as well. Like if you want to restrict the privileges, only people who are related to social media only they can access that manages, if they want to analyze the logs and they want to do the analytics on top of the entire logs, so they can do the analytics and using these all the data. So that's called this data. And we can processing this data using batch queries, interactive queries, real-time analytics, and machine learning and the data warehouse. So data warehouse, we can create data warehouse and we can store this data here, like using HD inset cluster. We can create Hive, and the data will be stored in your data lake store. This is a common usage for any type of data, ingesting your data and preparing your data and storing your data, then you are analyzing. So this is a common concept, a data lake you can use for any type of data. Normally if you have a database, what you can do, only structured data can be stored, and that you can use for analytics. But if you have a logs, unstructured data, if you have XML files, semi-structured data, if you want to analyze those data before going to my database, I don't want to store in my database, first I want to analyze that, so I don't have that much time to wait to convert this data, and you have to load this. So you can directly analyze structured data, semi-structured data, unstructured data. So what you have to do, you have to extract data from your sources, and you have to ingest your data into your data lake store, and then you have to prepare like cleanage and enriching, whatever you have options, you can implement those, and then storing warehouses, like you can store this data into your warehouse, Hive, like Hadoop, Hive you can store, or maybe as Azure SQL database or Azure Analyst Services, then you can analyze this data using analytic engines like Hadoop and Spark. Okay, so this is the common usage, this is called data lake store in Azure cloud. Okay, so what are the major features, V2 features? So Azure Data Lake version 2, that's a generation 2 is okay. Generation 1, it's a normal data lake folder structure, And generation 2, it is supporting with Azure Blob Storage. Okay, the generation 2, most of the features is included Azure Blob Storage features. So its ability to store and analyze data any kind of any size. Enterprise grade security with Azure Active Directory. So you can integrate with Azure Active Directory and you can give the privileges depending on your hierarchy, as well as hierarchical file system supports and read access geo redundant storage. So few folders, like few data, if you want to restrict only read only access, you can integrate with Active Directory. All the users you can again give only read access. That's also possible here. And 5 TB file size limit. So each file, so it will support a max 5 TB size file. And blob drives. So earlier data lake, this features is not there actually. If you look at the hot, cold, and archive storage type, this storage types is not available in data lake, but it is available in blob storage actually. So those, it is available in Azure Data Lake generation 2. Okay, generation 2. So multiple access methods. So if you store here and you can access including like multiple access means USQL, Spark, Hive, HBase, Storm, and so you can build on Yarn and HDFS clusters. So dynamic scaling to match your business priorities. So you can increase your based on your usage. For example, now you have a less capacity and less usage. Later, if you want to increase this scaling, so you can increase it dynamically. It will increase your scaling. So that's the concept of Azure Data Lake Generation 2 features. So I think this theoretically I'm explaining here. If you look at the practically, you will get more related to, you will get understand what exactly data lake store. So if this is my Azure portal, if you go to all resources, you can see available resources. I have a data lake store I have already created. So if you want to create a new data lake store, if you go to all resources, you can find here data lake store generation 1. So if you want to create a new data lake store, you can click on add. So here you need to give this name, it's a unique name, and your name with the complete URL you can see here, azuredatalakestore.net. So I'm giving RAVEELAKE. Then resource group. So if you want to create a new resource group, you can create, or you can, if you want to use existing resource group, you can use this. This is a resource group. And the location, this is my different services available, like Central US, East US, North Europe, and West Europe. So based on you can use this. And the pricing package also you can see here, monthly commitment or pay as you go. So how much you are going to use, that much it will give the billing. Then encryption settings also you can see here. So this is use keys managed with the data lake storage. So if you want to access from third party tools, so the data will be encrypted and you can access through encryption keys. So that I will show how to access and how to use the encryption keys. Let's create. So I'm going to create a new data lake storage account. See here, this is a unique name. So you can see here, there's a progress you can see here. Deployment is in progress. In alerts and notifications, you can see all whatever currently is in progress, whichever is completed. This is my earlier, whatever I have created and whatever I have deleted accounts or storages, you can see all the log. You can see all notifications. So once it's done, it will be available here. If you refresh, see here, it's my new data lake. And the folder symbol you can see here, there's a folder symbol, and the resource group also you can see here. There's a resource group and my location and my subscription. It's a free trial. I'm using a free trial subscription, and if click on this, still it's a progress. It will take a few more minutes. Let's wait for that. So in Azure portal, if you don't know which resource you are looking for, that simply you can search here and it will display like if you are looking for Azure Blob Storage or Data Lake or Virtual Machine or Load Balancer, whichever like virtual networks if you are looking, simply search that name like HD Insight Cluster, like HD it will display. This is a default, easily we can search, it's like a, okay, then so here you can see deployment succeeded. You can close this. This is my go to home. If you go to all resources, here you can see the resources whichever you have created. This is two resources, one is a two are both are data lake store generation one, you can see here. So once you open a data lake store, you can see the overview. This is the default tab is overview, and this is your data lake store name and your subscription. You can see pay as you go and estimated cost up to date. It's like as of now I have not stored any files here, that's why it is showing zero. And pricing tier info, if you want to see complete information, you can click on this, it will open new window. Here you can see complete pricing information, like whatever files you have stored, that will give you the based on your storage. So if you want to look folder wise, you can click, there is a option called Data Explorer. This is where you can create a new folder and copy the data. So I'm going to create a new folder, log folder, my sources files will be like I'm creating here, staging files like this. I'm creating multiple folders, target files. So other options you can see here, filter. For example, there are multiple folders in your project. If you want to search only few, for example you are looking for one folder, what you can do, you can click on filter and search for log. I'm looking for log folder, so it is filtered only log folder, remaining will be hidden. So like this you can create a filter, like I'm removing filters here, then creating a new folder, uploading the data directly. You can upload data or any files, structured, semi structured, any files you can upload here. And access related, if you want to give a complete access, here you can see this access and the owners. This is my username, and you can see this read, write and execute access. If you select this, that access will be provided. If you deselect this, access will be revoked. This related to access. Then if you want to upload a file, so I want to upload one file, then you can browse a file here. These are manually without any coding. So I'm uploading one file here. See, you can see the status completed. Okay, so I have uploaded the file. Okay, then you can, if you refresh here, click on more options and refresh, the file is available now. Then this is a folder options. If you can see here, this is a complete access, your path, access path, this ADL and your data lake store name and complete URL.net, and your folder name is this one. This is a complete access, your path. If you click on this, it will copy the path. If you want to use any of other applications, if you want to access this folder, you can use this path. Then if you want to access this file and if you want to get that complete path through this file, you can click on this file, and this options you can see here, format, you can change the file format, see here. And see, this is my file, and my file is having header, but default it is showing with header is 1, 2, 3, like this numbers. So you can select this first row is a header. So if you select this, so this will be disabled, and first row header will be displayed, and the number of rows is a 25, number of columns is a 250, like encoding auto detect, a delimiter is a comma, delimiter file this is, and click on OK. See, now my header is showing correctly. This is a format, file format you can change here. And download, if you want to download this file, you can download to your local system. If you want to rename the file, you can rename the file. Sales. So file has been renamed. Now you can see it's a sales file. Earlier it was export.csv file. Now it's a sales.csv file. Again you can see that format. Again you can see this. And properties also, you can see the properties. Complete path. If you want to use this file into different source system or target system, if you want to access this file, you can use this path. So there is another option called set expiry.